Well, staying with the politics of the day, Omoro County MP Jacob Olanya is vowing to, as he puts it, restore the reputation of Parliament as well as mend relations with the other two arms of government. The Honourable, who now is designated former Deputy Speaker, took the oath of allegiance today at Parliament and was among the last batch of legislators to compose the 11th Parliament. Let's have the details in the following report.
Jacob Logori Olanya, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I'll be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I'll preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
At 11 a.m., the outgoing Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, took oath to represent Omoro County for the fourth time. He pledged to facilitate social and economic transformation in his constituency.
Today, another journey begins. A journey of 5 years. A journey in which we must achieve a few things. And those things, we know them. Focus on uplifting the standard of education, healthcare, and that area is for agriculture. How do we deal with the issue of farmers? And overall, how do we achieve socio-economic transformation for those people?
Olanya, who is eyeing the speakership, said the image of Parliament had degenerated in the last 5 years, something he hopes to change once elected as Speaker of the 11th Parliament.
My honest assessment is the next 5 years of Parliament should not be like the last 5 years. There are things we must change. Whether I am there or not, there are things that should change. And there are many. We have to restore public confidence in this institution. This is the only parliament where parliamentarians, wherever they are seen, they are jeered at.
He wants parliament to divorce from rhetoric talks and focus the discussion on the general well-being of citizens.
When we sit in parliament, we are no longer FDC, NRM. We sit as a national parliament determining the cause of the lives of the people of this country. That's what we sit as. And if you're talking about service, better service delivery, you cannot have two sides to it. We can only stand as one people, one parliament, representing the people of God. If you're talking about protecting the national interest, we can only stand as one person, representing the interest of this country.
Olanya, who is challenging his former boss Rebecca Kadaga, pledged to amend relations with other organs of government. He said protecting the independence of parliament will not stop it from working with other organs of government. Other contestants in the race for speaker, including Ibrahim Semuju Nganda, the member of parliament for Kira municipality on the FDC ticket, Richard Sebamala, the MP of Bukoto Central on the DP ticket, and Juliet Subi Chinyamatama, the woman MP for Rakai district, also revealed their campaign strategies for a victory.
On Monday, we will be electing the speaker of the 11th parliament. I have finished the swearing in. I am going to be doing the final touches, calling MPs, sending them messages, and also reminding them, because I have been using an analogy of a herdsman. When he sells his cattle, he doesn't go on the beef market demanding to be served the meat of his cattle. He wants the best meat that is available.
I'm aware that NRM has not chosen a speaker, so we don't know who we are standing against. But whatever the case, by Monday, we shall know, by Sunday midnight, we shall know who we are standing against, and then we shall sort out the right strategies. The only reason why they have not chosen a speaker, one of them by now, is because they don't want us to now look for the other bit, for the other batch. But all in all, we are ready. Personally, I'm ready.
The deputy speakership race is also catching steam, with 5 candidates swearing in today. They include Jacob Obothoboth, the MP for West Budama Central, Dennis Oguzu, the MP for Maracha County, Thomas Tayewa, the MP for Rugunda North, Robina Ruakojo, the MP for Gomba West, and Theodore Sechikubo, the MP for Lwemiyaga County.
I cannot go against SEC or NRM party, and my conviction is that SEC will be impressed with my profile, with my history, with my ability and skills in handling parliamentary matters.
I'm the only candidate whom supporters from both camps have converged on, because I speak a message of unity, I speak a message of respect, and I speak a message of working with each and everyone that will win the office of Speaker. There is no anything like an alliance in this parliament, no. Those are statements made by people who would want maybe to get sympathy somewhere. I know there is a person I'm going to vote for the post of Speaker.
We were asked to take applications there and attach our CVs, and it's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm competent, as I've told you, because I have vast legal experience, having worked in the Ministry of Justice and Constitutional Affairs for a long time. And when I came here to Parliament, I got into leadership.
This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News in Kampala.